Hello students, this video lecture is for class 6th, subject GK, page number 16, and today we are going to learn about animals and types of animals. So let's start. There are many different animal classes, and every animal in the world belongs to one of them. The five most well-known classes of vertebrates. Now, vertebrates means those animals which have a spinal cord or backbone. So, classes of vertebrates are mammals, birds, fish, reptiles, amphibians. They are all part of phylum Chordata. Now, Chordata means a spinal cord. There are also a lot of animals without backbones. These are called invertebrates, and are part of phylum Arthropoda or arthropods. Pods. Two of the most commonly known class in the phylum are arachnids, which are spiders, and insects. Now, first we will be seeing about mammals. People are mammals, so are dogs, cats, horses, duckbills, and platypuses, kangaroos, dolphins, and whales. What do all these animals have in common, do you ask? And the answer is milk. These all animals have one thing common, which is they drink milk when they are baby. And also has hairs on its body, so it belongs to the mammal class. So if you have given a list of animals and anyone asks you to select a mammal or pick out a mammal, you have to know these two important properties of a mammal. First is they drink milk when they are baby, and they have hairs on their body. Next are birds. Now, birds are animals that have feathers and that are born out of hard shelled eggs. All birds have feathers, and birds are the only animals that do. These feathers on a bird's wings and tail overlap. Because they overlap, the feathers catch and hold the air. This helps the bird to fly, steer itself, and land. Now, before moving forward, I just want to tell you that bats also fly, but bats are not birds. They are mammals. So now let's move forward. Birds, as we know, birds have feathers. And all those who have feathers can be classified as birds. And what these feathers do? They help in catching and holding air, which helps bird to fly in the air. Now, last is fish. Fish are vertebrates that live in water and have gills, scales, and fins on their body. There are a lot of different fish, and many of them look very odd indeed. There are blind fish, fish with noses like elephants, fish that shoot down passing bugs with a stream of water, and even fish that crawl onto land and hop about. So fish are also vertebrates, and which have gills to breathe oxygen in the water, scales, and fins on their body. There are very different fishes in the world, and some of them are very old also. Few fish are blind because they live deep under the ocean where there is no sunlight, so they do not need eyes there. Few fish has noses like elephant. Few fish shoots water out of the lake, river to the nearby bug who is passing by, and that bug falls in the water and that fish eats it. And few fish also crawl on the land and hop about. Now next is amphibians. Amphibians are born in water when they are born. They breathe with gills like a fish, but when they grow up, they develop lungs and can live on land too. So amphibians are those animals which can live in land and also in water. But amphibians are born in the water, and few days until they become adult, they live in the water and breathe like fish using their gills. But they, when they become adult, they develop lungs and can live in the land too. Now next is arthropods. Arthropods is a huge phylum of animals. It includes 11 animal classes, which are Merostomata, Phycnogonida, Arachnida, Remipedia, Cephalocarida, Branchiphora, Maxillopoda, Melacostraca, Chilpoda, Diplopoda, and Insecta. Any animals that have more than four jointed legs are arthropods. Insects, spiders, and crustaceans all belong to this class of animals. So all those who have more than four jointed legs come to arthropods category. Few of them are such as a spider and insects and crustaceans. So this was your page number 16 and 17. Next will be your page 18 and 19 in the next video. Thank you.